Hey everybody, Craig with singlelengthschool.com here, bringing you our tip of the week. So typically, I would have loved to be outside today. The weather's cooperating somewhat in terms of temperature, but in terms of being able to get outside and give you a tip with a swing or something like that, we got a little bit of rain today, so I'm not gonna be able to get outside to give you a tip, but I've got a different type of tip for you that actually I've had probably about five or six of this same question. So I do want to share some of this information with you. I think it's very valuable to everybody out there, not just the single length guys. But one of the things that comes up and a lot of people ask is, how do I warm up for my round? What should my routine be? How am I going to get the best out of my game with a pre-round warm-up? And this is a great question, because one of the things as amateurs that we all recognize is we're not able to get out and practice every day of the week. We're not golfing 40 hours a week. So our bodies don't adjust. Our bodies aren't of the same caliber as pros, at least most of the amateurs. Some AMs are able to get out there quite a bit and get a lot of practice in. But when it comes to preparing for a round, one of the biggest things you have to remember is your body doesn't have the stamina that the typical pro does. So thinking that you need to go out and have a range session before your round like the pros do and hit balls for an hour, that's not good, because your body's not accustomed to it. You're going to wear yourself out halfway through the round. You're going to see your scores actually start to get worse because your body's going to tire out. So what is the ideal warm-up before a round? I'm not saying don't hit the range. I'm not saying don't hit putts and chips, but from working with students and doing it myself, there seems to be kind of a good balance of what to do pre-round on the range and getting into the round so that you don't tire yourself out. So here's the suggestions I have for your pre-round warm-up. First of all, get to the course about an hour early, so you have time to get to the range, hit some putts and things like that. So when you get to the course, stretch. Do some stretches so you're not hurting yourself on the range. Next, go to the range first. Why the range first? Because after you're done with the range, you can give your muscles a little bit of time to recoup. So I usually spend about 20, 25 minutes max on the range. And what I'm looking at is, I'm not looking at hitting a large bucket or a large bag of balls. I only want to hit about 30 shots just to warm up the muscles and just to get my body in that routine. So typically I'll start with a 7-iron, hit 5 shots. Then from 7-iron, I'll drop down to one of my wedges and hit another 5 shots. Now I'm 10 shots in. Then I'll jump up to one of my long irons, or single length case, a 4 or 5, 6 iron, something in there, and I'll hit 5 shots. So now I'm up to 15. I'm halfway through that bucket or that bag of balls. Now I'll hit about 7 drivers. So that gets me to 22, just to make sure I work out those kinks with the driver. Then I'll go back and hit an 8 or a 9 iron, hit 3 shots with the 8 or a 9. Now I'm at 25. And then finally, I wrap it up with 5 more wedges, whether it's, some longer pitch shots, something like that. But that's it. Just enough to get the muscles warm, get some full swings in, but not enough to tire yourself out. That typically hitting 30 balls should take you about 30 minutes. So your hour before, you're 30 minutes in, you got 30 minutes now before your tee time. That's where I head to the green. So once I get to the green, now I'm going to chip about 15, 20 balls, get the feel of working around the green. If there's a practice bunker, hit 5 shots out of the bunker. Spend about 10 minutes or so chipping around the green. Then I've got 20 minutes left before my tee time. I spend 15 of it putting. So just different length putts. Typically what I'll do is, and you see a lot of pros do it, start from about 3 feet away, knock in 5, 6, 7 putts, bump back to 6 feet, bump back to 10 feet, bump back to 15 or 20 feet, and just keep working so you can get the speed of the greens. Once I'm done putting, I give myself, you know, 5 minutes before my tee time. I use the restroom, get a drink, head to the tee, do a little bit more stretching, and I'm good to go. So it's not, you don't want to overcomplicate or overdo it when you're warming up before your round. You don't want those muscles to become tired after the ninth hole. You want to make sure you're still energized, still refreshed. So hitting the range first and giving yourself about 30 minutes before your tee time, then hitting the green, chipping, putting, things like that, there, it's going to allow your major swing muscles. It's not enough time for them to tighten up, but it's enough time for them to regain their strength and regain their energy so that you don't get tired out on the course. So guys, that's the tip of the week. Make sure you warm up the right way. Don't overdo it. And when you warm up the right way, you'll see your scores get lower. You'll have better results out on the course. So next week we'll bring something else for you. Hopefully the weather cooperates and I can get back out on the course and show you something a little bit different. Maybe we'll bounce around and come off the single length irons, and maybe we'll do a driver or a putter tip next week, something like that. But guys, again, thanks for everybody that's watching. Thanks for everybody that keeps following, all the messages, all the comments. Guys, we love it. Don't forget, on the website, go to our partners and then click on Sterling Irons, and you can go over to Sterling Irons, check out their product. Also, if you purchase through them, they're going to kick back to Single Length School so we can help continue to bring you great content. They'll help fund some of the things that we want to do. So guys, if you're looking at a set of single length irons, any set's great, but if you're looking for something a little higher end, you know, mid price range, Sterling Irons are a great option. And like I said, they kick back to Single Length School, so be sure to check that out. Again, that's the Our Partners tab on our website at singlelengthschool.com. Also, go to singlelengthschool.com, sign up for a membership, jump into those tips and tricks. The memberships are free. It also gives you access to the forum where you can go back and forth with other guys that are in the single length and follow us. And, you know, there's always great questions and great tips in there as well. At Single Length School on Facebook and Instagram, make sure you go over, follow us there. On Twitter, it's at One Length School. YouTube, go over, subscribe to YouTube as well. It's great. It'll notify you every time that we set out a new video. So guys, make sure you keep following. Tell your friends, tell your family, come check it out. Even for those that don't like single length or aren't committed to single length yet, great resources no matter what. There's certain things that can help them as well. So guys, we appreciate it. Singlelengthschool.com, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, YouTube. Follow us. We love it. And remember, size matters. Choose single length. Thanks, guys.